Parallel lines, a circle with a radius of 2 units, and a center Q is drawn below. Which of these points could be located on the circle? So let's start with negative 2, 2. Starting at the origin, negative 2 tells me to go to the left, 2 on the x-axis, and up 2 on the y. That does not hit my circle on the edge. Therefore, A is not the answer. Negative 1, 0 starting at 0, 0. That means I'm going to go back 1 and up nowhere. That does not hit the circle either. 1, 3, I'll start at 0, 0. Go over 1 on the x, up 1, 2, 3. That's within the circle but not on the edge. Therefore, C is not my answer. D, 3, 2, I'll start at 0, 0 at the origin. Over 1, 2, 3 on the x, up 2 on the y. That puts it right at the edge and tells me that D is my answer. Moving on, angle relationships and parallel lines. When two lines intersect, they form two pairs of opposite angles called vertical angles. Let's take a look. We've got two lines that do intersect. Angles 1 and 2 are not vertical, but angle 1 and 3 are. They are intersecting lines. They share a vertex and they're across from each other. Angles 1 and 3 are vertical and they are what we call congruent because they are the same angle measure. So we could also say the same for 2 and 4. They are vertical because they're across from each other, and because they're vertical, they are congruent and equal measure. Moving on. When two angles in a plane have the same vertex, share a common side, and do not overlap, they are called adjacent angles. I like to say they're right next door to each other. So if you have two angles, such as this angle and this angle, that share a side, also have the same vertex right down here, and that don't overlap, well, they're adjacent to each other. So this angles 1 and 2 are going to be adjacent. Angles 1 and 2 up here are also adjacent. You could say the same about 2 and 3 are adjacent. They're next door. They share a side. And 1 and 4 are also adjacent. Moving on. If the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degrees, the angles are complementary. The smaller of the two, if you have two angles that add up to 180, that's supplementary. But complementary is where two angles add up to 90 degrees. So if we did have a 90 degree angle with a the square here denoting that it is 90 degrees, a right angle, then split it, then we could say that this angle and this angle add up to 90 degrees and that they are complementary to each other. So angles 1 and 2 are complementary. They add up to 90 degrees. I will make the point that they don't have to be right next to each other to be complementary. You could have two separate angles that add up to 90 and still be complementary to each other. You could also have different, this doesn't have to be 45 and 45 degree angles. You could have 70, you could have 70, 20, you could have 60, 30. As long as they add up to 90 degrees, then they are going to be complementary to each other. So if you find the sum of the angle 1 and angle 2, you should get 90 degrees. Moving on, if the sum of the measures of two angles is 180 degrees, they are supplementary. They add up together. Let's take a look. If we have a straight line, we already know that a straight line, a straight angle, as they call it, is 180 degrees. If you split that into two separate angles with a ray in this instance, then you could add those two angles and say that they are 180 degrees and supplementary. If you find the sum of angle 1 and angle 2, you should get 180 degrees. So they're supplementary to each other because they add up to 180. I will make the point again that they don't have to be right next door to each other. You'd have two angles that are separate and add up to 180 degrees and still be supplementary. Let's move on. For this example, find the value of x. Notice that x is across from 34. They have the same vertex. Two lines intersecting and they're right across from each other. You know that they are going to be vertical to each other. And if they're vertical, they're also the same measure, also called congruent. So because x and 34 are vertical, you could say that they're the same measure and that x is going to be 34 because they're vertical to each other. So angle 152 and x are not vertical. 152 is vertical to this angle down here. That means that these two angles are not going to be congruent, but we can say that since this is a straight line and it's cut, that straight line is cut, that this is 180 degrees and is supplementary, meaning that we could subtract 180 from 152 from 180 and find that missing angle right here. So 180 minus 152 is 28 degrees. So this angle measure X is 28 degrees. Moving on, angle X and angle Y are complementary, meaning they add up to 90 degrees. Find the measure of angle X if the measure of angle Y is 30 degrees. So if we know they add up to 90, what we could do is set up an equation. The unknown, we will place an X for the unknown angle measure X. And we will say X plus the 30 degrees is equal to 90 because they've already stated that it's complementary. To get rid of a plus 30, you could subtract 30 from both sides, and we would get X equals 60 degrees for the missing angle degree measure angle Y. Number four, angle A and angle B are supplementary, meaning they add up to 180 degrees. The measure of angle A is X plus 14 degrees. Notice that's not a specific number. It's an algebraic expression representing the measure of angle A. And the measure of angle B is going to be equal to X minus 20 degrees. Find the measure of each angle. Well, we know that since they're supplementary, that we can add A and B and get 180 degrees. And we will substitute these expressions, X plus 14 for A and X minus 20 for B, and set that equal to 180 degrees because A plus B does equal 180 degrees since they're supplementary. We are now going to add like terms. We can only add the terms if they have the exact same variables to the exact same exponent. So right here I have two X's, both to the first. So this is X and X. I do get to add those because they have the exact same letter. I don't get to add those to 14 and negative 20. But 1X plus 1X is 2X. I get to also add the 14 and the negative 20 because those are just numbers, also called constants. So 14 plus a negative 20 is negative 6. Notice we did not add the 2x and the negative 6 since they were not like terms. From there, since we have combined our like terms, we get to solve. What you would get rid of first, since we're doing backwards PEMDAS, we're going to get rid of addition and subtraction before the multiplication division. To get rid of a minus 6, you'll add 6. And to get rid of a minus 6, to add 180 plus 6, that will be 186. Therefore, we have 2x equals 186. Then this is 2 times x. The opposite of multiplication is division. We'll divide 186 by 2, and half of 186 is 93. So understand, x equals 93, that doesn't tell me what the measure of angle A is or the measure of angle B. That's not a degree measure. That's only what x is. So what we have to do is substitute 93 in for x, for A, and for B. Let's start with A. This is going to be 93 plus 14 since x is 93. 93 plus 14 is 107 degrees, which is the full degrees measure for angle A. Let's do the same for B. We'll substitute 93 in place of X. We will get 93 minus 20 since it says X minus 20 for the measure of angle B. 93 minus 20 is 73 degrees for the measure degrees of measure, the measure of angle B. Moving on, when two parallel lines are intersected by a third called a transversal, eight angles are formed. Let's take a look at those. Here's our two parallel lines. There's the transversal, very important today. And then we have eight separate angles that are constructed by this, that are created by this relationship. And there are several relationships to go over. Let's start with the corresponding angles, angle 1 and angle 5. Notice angle 1 and angle 5 are on the same side of this transversal, but one of them is on the inside of the parallel lines. One of them is on the outside. I like to think of it as sitting in movie theaters. You have a person sitting in front of you, like angle 1 and 5. But just keep in mind, for corresponding, you do have to be on the same side of this transversal, like 1 and 5. One on the inside of the parallel lines, one on the outside. And the nice thing about corresponding angles is that they're the same. They are congruent, the same angle measure. The same for 2 and 6. Notice, same side of this transversal, one on the inside of the parallel lines, one on the outside. Still corresponding, still the same angle measure. Angles 3 and 7 are corresponding because one of them is on the inside of the parallel lines, one's on the outside. They're both on the same side of the transversal. Angles 4 and 8, one on the inside of the parallel lines, one on the outside, both on the same side of this transversal, making them corresponding, and they have the same angle measure. Let's move on. Alternate interior angle. So interior means these 4, 3, 5, and 6, all of those are interior to the parallel lines. They're on the inside of the parallel lines, but it just so happens that 3 and 5 are on alternate sides of this transversal. 3 and 5 are alternate interior because they are on different sides of this transversal, but they're both on the interior of these parallel lines, and it just so happens that they are also the same angle measure. So 3 and 5, if you notice, they look about to be maybe 120 degrees, and so they're the same opening, the same angle measure. They're congruent. So 4 and 6 are also alternate interior angles. Let's move on to alternate exterior angles. And as you guessed, probably they're exterior to these parallel lines. 1 and 2, 8 and 7, they're exterior to the two blue parallel lines. And so to make them alternate exterior, we have to be on alternate sides of this transversal. So 1 and 7 are on opposite sides of the transversal, but they're exterior to the two blue parallel lines. So angles 1 and 7 are alternate exterior angles, and they're the same angle measure, making them congruent. So 2 and 8 are also alternate exterior angles. Let's move on to probably the most important relationship we could tell you today, which would be same side interior angles. 4 and 5, they're on the same side of this transversal. They are going to not be congruent. All these other ones have been congruent, meaning the same angle measure. But this is the first one where they add up to 180 degrees, making them supplementary. So angle 4 and 5, for them to be same side interior, they're on the same side of the transversal, and they're on the interior of the parallel lines. So 4 and 5 are going to be same side interior, and they will add up to 180 degrees. 3 and 6 are also same side interior. They're on the same side of the transversal. They're interior to the parallel lines, and so they will be same side interior, and they're supplementary because they will add up to 180 degrees. Let's use that to find the missing angle measure. So angle 1 is going to be 130 degrees. Angle 2, which is right next door, this is a straight line. And if I cut that straight line, then that will give me two angles that add up to 180 degrees. They are supplementary because this is a straight angle. Then we would say that 180 minus 130 will give us 2. 180 minus 130 is 50. Notice right across from 1 is 3. They're vertical to each other. We know that they are congruent. So since angle 1 is 130, we could say angle 3 is also 130. Right next door to, or actually we'll say vertical to 2 is 4. We know that 2 and 4 are going to be congruent as well. So angle 2 is 50, angle 4 is 50. Notice that 4 and 5 are same side interior. Remember from the slide before that they add up to 180 degrees. So what could we do since we already know that angle 4 is 150? We could subtract from 180. 180 minus 50 will give us 130 degrees for angle 5. We could do the same for angles 3 and 6. These are same side interior. So since angle 3 is 130 degrees, we could subtract 130 from 180. 180 minus 130 is 50 degrees for angle 6 because they are same side interior. From there, we're going to use our vertical relationships. 5 and 7 have to be equal because they're vertical to each other. So since angle 5 is 130, angle 7 is 130 because they are vertical to each other. Angle 6 and 8 are also vertical, so they will be congruent. So since angle 6 is 50, angle 80 is also 50 because they are vertical to each other. Number one, use a figure for exercises 1 through 4. Looking over here, we have a pair of parallel lines and a transversal cutting through those two, giving us all the relationships that we spoke of before. So for number one, angle UVY, that's UVY, that's this angle right here, and blank are a pair of corresponding angles. If you remember, for corresponding, you need the same side of this transversal right here. The angles all over on the, need to be on this side, but one needs to be on the outside of the parallel lines. One needs to be on the inside. So we're talking about this angle right here. And remember that your middle letter needs to be your vertex. So if I am speaking of this angle that's corresponding with this angle, one is inside, one's outside, same side of the transversal, then we would say that this would be VWZ, and the middle letter is your vertex. Again, that's VWZ. Let me make the point that you could have used U as well, UWZ, and you would get the same angle, which is this angle right here. Number two, angle WVY, and let's look at that one, WVY, WVY, that's this one right here, and VWT, that's VWT, are what to each other? Well, if you notice, they are both on the inside of the parallel lines. One of the one of them is on this side of the transversal, one's on the other side. They are on alternate sides of the transversal, making them alternate interior angles. Okay, moving on. Number three, find the measure of angle SVW, and that's going to go along with the measure of, for number four, VWT, because if you notice for both of those, SVW, that's this guy right here, and VWT, that's this one right here. Both of those are same side interior. That is very important to us right now, because if you remember from before, if they are the same side of this transversal and they're both interior to the parallel lines, they are supplementary to each other. What does that mean? That means they add up to 180 degrees. So what we will do is add up 4x plus 5x and set that equal to 180 degrees. Let's combine like terms. 4x plus 5x, they both have x's. We get to add those. That'll be 9x equals 180 degrees. Then we will divide both sides by 9. Therefore, x equals 180 divided by 9 is 20. Know that that does not mean that that is the angled measures for SVW. This only means that x is 20. Since it says for x, we can use that to find SVW. Let's do that. We know that that is 4x degrees for SVW. We can substitute in place of x. We could say 4 times what we know is x, which is 20. 4 times 20 would be 80 degrees. Now we have the actual angle measure. But for number four, find VWT, the other same side interior angle, is 5x. So we will write that as 5x, but replace the x with the 20 that we found from before. 5 times 20 is 100 degrees for the other same side interior angle. Number five, vocabulary: when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, much like this right here, the two parallel lines, blank angles are supplementary. Well, it just so happens that we went over that. The two that are supplementary to each other were the same side of the transversal of this line right here and interior to the parallel lines. So same side interior angles. All right, they are supplementary. They add up to 180 degrees. Number six, what can you conclude about the interior angles formed when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal? Well, there's a couple of relationships. If we're talking about interior angles, we could look down here at these two lines that are parallel that are cut by a transversal, and we could recognize that 3 and 6 are alternate interior, and we know that they are the same. If you look at them, they're the same opening. Like, for instance, if 3 is 60, then 6 is also going to be 60. So we could say that to start, we'll say alternate Interior. Angles are congruent, meaning they are the same angle measure. So if they are on the alternate sides of the transversal, like 3 and 6, here's your transversal, alternate sides of the transversal, but interior to the parallel lines. That's alternate interior, and you know they're going to be exactly the same angle measure. And then what did we talk about before? At length over here, we said that the same side interior angles add up to 180 degrees, which means they're supplementary. So let's state that as well. Same side interior angles are going to be supplementary, meaning they add up to 180 degrees. All right, number 7, name all the pairs of corresponding angles. Remember, one on the inside, one on the outside, same side of the transversal. So that's the rules for corresponding. So one on the inside of the parallel lines, one on the outside, but same side of the transversal. And 3 and 7 are definitely in that category. Let me scoot that over. So it'd be 3 and angle 7 are both corresponding to each other. Let's get another pair. We know that angle 1 is on the outside, angle 5 is on the inside of the parallel lines, but they're both on the same side of this transversal. So we could say angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding. All right, let's do another pair. How about angle 4 and angle 8? Those are also one on the inside of the parallel lines, one on the outside, and same side of this transversal over here. So we could say angle 4 and angle 8 are corresponding and congruent, as a matter of fact. And then lastly, what about angle 2 on the outside of the parallel lines, angle 6 on the inside, same side of the transversal? That's going to be corresponding as well. So number 8, name both pairs of alternate exterior angles. Exterior is outside of the parallel lines. What are we talking about? We're talking about these two and these two. Those are exterior to your parallel lines. For alternate exterior, they have to be on either side of this transversal. So angle 7 and angle 2 are on alternate sides of this transversal. So that is the first pair. We'll say angle 2 and angle 7 are alternate exterior. And then also we could see that angle 1 and angle 8 are also outside of the parallel lines, but on alternate sides of this transversal right here. So angle 1 and angle 8 are alternate exterior. Number 9, name the relationship between 3 and 6. Notice they're both inside the parallel lines, making them interior, if you remember that, the interior of those two. And since there's one they're on opposite sides of this transversal cutting through, you would say that they are alternate interior. All right. Number 10, name the relationship between angle 4 and angle 6. Well, angle 4 is on the inside. Angle 6 is on the inside. So they're interior. So we'll start with that. But then we also know that they're on the same side of the transversal, making them same side interior angles. And we know that those are supplementary as well. Number 11, find each angle measure. So let's start with the measure of AGE. That's AGE right here. When FHD is 30, so FHD, we're saying that that is 30 degrees. Well, if you notice, those are alternate sides of this transversal, either side of the transversal, exterior, because they are outside of the parallel lines, making them congruent. So if this one is 30, then this one also is 30 degrees. All right, moving on. The measure of angle AGH, that's AGH, this angle right here, when the measure of CHF is 150. CHF is 150. So right there, if you notice, these are on the same side of this transversal, but one is on the inside and one is on the outside of the parallel lines, making them corresponding angles. And we know the corresponding angles are equal and congruent. So if this one is 150, so is AGH. All right, moving on. That's because they're corresponding angles. Number 13, CHF when BGE is 110 degrees. So let's look at CHF. We just talked about that one. We want to know what that one is. If BGE is 110 degrees. So looking at that, BGE is over here. CHF is over here. Those are, again, on the outside of the parallel lines. So they're exterior, but they're on alternate sides of this transversal, making them alternate exterior and also congruent. So since they said that BGE is 110 degrees, we know that CHF is also 110 degrees. Look at number 14, CHG, when HGA is 120. CHG, that's this one right here. When H, let's put that in purple just so we can differentiate. CHG, when HGA, that's HGA, is 120. HGA is right here. So we know that these two angles, this one and this one, CHG and HGA, are same side interior. And that's our special case to where we know that those aren't congruent to each other. They are supplementary, meaning they add up to 180 degrees. So if they're already telling us that HGA is 120, right here, if this is 120, that we could subtract to get this missing angle right here. So let's do that. We'll say 180 minus the 120 degrees, which will give us 60 degrees for CHG. All right, number 15, we're looking for BGH, and we really, if you notice, BGH has a special expression, 3x. And so in order to find that, we're also going to need to incorporate GHD, which is GHD, this angle right here, because these two both are expressions. They both are have an X involved, 3X and then 2X plus 50. So we know that these two are also same side interior, making them supplementary. So we are going to do use the same idea that they add up to 180 degrees. We will add 3x plus 2x plus 50. We'll add both of these expressions and set them equal to 180 because we know same side interior angles, this one and this one, same side of the transversal, this line, and interior to those two lines, the parallel lines, then we get to add those up and set them equal to 180. We're only going to add like terms. These two have X's, so we can add 3X and 2X, which is 5X, plus 50 equals 180 degrees. From there, we will do backwards PEMDAS, and we're going to get rid of the plus 50. The opposite of plus 50 is minus 50. We get rid of addition, subtraction before multiplication, division. We'll bring down the 5X. Equal to 180 minus 50 is 130. The opposite of multiplication, 5 times x is division. So we will divide by itself. We'll divide by 5. What will that give us? That will give us x, because the 5s cancel, equals 130 divided by 5 is 26. That is not the answer to BGH. Instead, it tells us that BGH is 33X. So we'll use the fact that that's 3 times what X is. X is 26. So we are going to substitute the x in place, 26 in place of x. So that'll be 3 times the 26. And 3 times 26 is 78 degrees for BGH. That was originally 3x. Let's move on to GHD, which is going to be the 2x plus 50. I'll write that above, 2x plus 50. But again, we're going to substitute the fact that x is 26. So that will be 2 times 26 plus the 50 right next to it. So 2 times 26 is 52 plus the 50 makes it 102 degrees for GHD after we substitute 26 in for X. Let's look at 17. The cross country bike trail follows a straight line. That's this one right here. Where it crosses 350th and 360th streets. The two streets are parallel to each other. What is the measure of the larger angle formed at the intersection of the bike trail 360th Street and the bike trail? And so out of, if you look at 360th right here and the bike trail, they cross and they make a smaller angle and a larger angle. We're looking for this guy right here. And we're going to use the fact that these are same side interior, like we talked about with this problem above. And so since it is same side interior, we can use the fact that they add up to 180 degrees. What does that mean to us? Well, I have 48 degrees right here. So I know that they are supposed to add up to 180. To find the missing angle, all I would have to do is subtract the 180 and the 48, and I will find the leftovers. And that's going to give me 132 degrees for that larger angle that is created by the intersection of the cross country bike trail and 360th Street. All right, number 18. How many different angles would be formed by a transversal intersecting three parallel lines? And how many different angle measures would there be? Well, if you notice, I went ahead and made three parallel lines, and then we intersected that with a transversal. And if you notice, if we numbered those, there are 12 different angles, and it's worth drawing. So please draw that ahead of time so you can see the same thing. And then from there, let's go ahead and walk through the different angle measures. Let me start with one. I know that angle one and angle three are vertical to each other. Therefore, they are equal. I still only have one angle measure. We'll say that's maybe 120 and 120. I also know that 3 and 5 are corresponding to each other because they're on the interior of these two parallel lines, and their alternate sides, their alternate interior, alternate sides of this transversal. So those are equal. 5 and 7 are vertical to each other, so they are equal. 7 and 9 are alternate interior to each other, interior of these two parallel lines and alternate sides of the transversal, so they're equal. 9 and 11 are also equal because of vertical. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and 11, all of those are the same angle measure, approximately maybe 110 degrees. So from there, from all that, we could tell that was only one angle measure. Let's also evaluate 2 and 4. Those are vertical to each other. 4 and 6 are alternate interior to each other. 6 and 8 are vertical to each other. 8 and 10 are alternate interior. 10 and 12 are vertical to each other. I say all that to tell you that every one of those in green are the same angle measure as well, approximately 70 degrees. So if that's the case, then we know that there's only two different angle measures. There were 12 total angles, but there were only two different angle measures. Last one, number 19, in the diagram at the right, suppose that angle 6 is 125 degrees. Let's go ahead and write that in here. And explain how to find the measures of each of the other seven numbered angles. Well, let's start with the fact that angle 7 is vertical to angle 6. And we know that that's going to be 125 degrees. So let's write that. Angle 7 is equal to 125 degrees because it is vertical. Angle 7 is vertical to angle 6. They're right across from each other. Let's move on to angle 3. Angle 3 is alternate interior to angle 6. They're on the same, they're on alternate sides of the transversal, but interior to the parallel lines. So we could say that they are the same. So angle 3 is also 125 degrees because of alternate interior angles. It's alternate interior to angle 6. Let's move on. Angle 2 compared to 6 is on the outside when angle 6 is on the inside, but they're on the same side of the transversal. And we know that it's 125 degrees because those two are corresponding to each other. So we could say it's corresponding to angle 6. All right. Next, angle 4. Angle 4 compared to angle 6 is same side interior. Notice they're both inside of the parallel lines, but they're on the same side of each other, making them supplementary. So we could say angle 4, we could, since they're same side interior, we know they're supplementary. So we could say 180 minus 125, and when we subtract those, we get 55 degrees. So angle 4 is actually going to be 55 degrees, and the reason for that is it is same side interior to angle 6. All right, moving on. Angle 5 is actually supplementary to angle 6 because this is a straight angle. And so we know that a straight line is 180 degrees. 180 minus 125, we already found out was 55. So we know that angle 5 is going to be 55 degrees as well, because it is supplementary to angle 6. We could say the same thing about angle 8, since 6 and 8, they also form a straight line. So angle 8 falls in line with angle 5, and they are both 55 degrees because they're supplementary to angle 6. Last one, angle 1 is equal to 55 degrees as well. And the reason why this time is because we've already figured out angle 4 was 55 degrees because they were same side interior, 4 and 6 were. But because angle 4 is vertical to angle 1, we can say that angle 1 is also 55 because of vertical angles. Hope this helps. Have a great day.